Good morning, good afternoon, good evening, depending from where you are cutting us from. My name is Dilango Gonjiri. I'm a University of Nairobi PhD student. First, I wish to thank the organizers of this conference, Africa Commons Web Conference 2020. It's a great pleasure for them giving me the opportunity to present in this conference. And for them to be able to organize this virtual conference in a very short time. And despite the challenges we have in COVID-19, we're able to have the conference going on. Thanks so much for the organizers. And thank you so much for joining me for this conference. Today, my topic, they will be discussing on fighting inequality to beat poverty in developing countries. And an introduction. You can see in this photo, an introduction part of it. This is the biggest slum we have in Africa, the Soweto slum in South Africa. And you can see the differences that the big difference you have here. You can see the environmental issue is a problem, no trees, no green vegetation. You can see no drainage, no water system, no power lines. No road system, and you see the living conditions are poor, and also see the congestion and fully populated area. And this is happening in the developing countries in Africa, and this has made us to be more in unequal with other countries in the world. And that's why I have come to this paper, I have come to this paper to be able to present the inequality and how to beat it. Having equality as one of my area that I have a lot of interest in on global on having global equality and reducing poverty levels globally. And you see the root cause of inequality and poverty is a big puzzle that requires many approaches for us to solve it. And then you need all the approaches to work in harmony for us to succeed. For example, when you talk of climate change, when you talk of poverty reduction, when you talk on wealth creation, all the SDGs programs that they have between, we have to work together on all the SDG program so that we can be able to harmonize the inequality and poverty level in the developing country. And for us to have a lasting solution in having for solving the inequality, we need innovation and to work together to end this inequality among the poor people. Because among the poor people, you find most of them they are not involved in any innovation work, and also they are not involved in any gainful employment that the people can bring better income for them. Also, you find inequality is a recipe, is a recipe where ingredients need to be blended. If you are blending all the ingredients together, for us to have one right direction, to be good for us to be able to solve the inequality in this world. From this photo, this is from Marunda Estate, a suburb area in Nairobi, Kenya. And you can see compared to Soweto, here we have parking areas where you have car parked, you have green environment. You can see the houses, we have good sanitation, you have good water system, you have power line, the electricity, the roofing of these houses, they are better. You see the space, it's very spacious compared to Soweto in South Africa. This is some of the inequality. You should try to think how the housing inequality, the environmental inequality, the wealth inequality, these are some of the inequality that you're supposed to look about. The purpose of this study is to understand and to understand how fighting inequality can be used to reduce poverty. But this we mean, how can we fight inequality? When you have less inequality, the poverty levels in the developing country will definitely go down. Those unpaid or underpaid employees will be able to get more paid income. And also, from the purpose, another purpose is to understand the SDG inequality and poverty reduction. Remember, under the UN, we have one of the major SDG is how to fight inequality and reduce poverty globally. So, how can we do this in Africa to us to reduce this inequality? Another purpose of the study is to foster economic growth and development. After knowing this, the inequality level in the developing country, how can we foster faster economic growth and development? Those slums in Soweto and the other part of the developing country, how can we solve all those problems and have a better economic growth and development? Another purpose of the study is to ensure the stability in other countries in the developing world, whereby every developing country is stable. Because you find in all developing countries, those who are unequal, you have a lot of crime rate is very high, you find a lot of civil, they are very high. So how can we make this country stable by having the equal levels of growth? The objectives of this study is to determine the inequality and poverty levels. So how can you know the levels of the inequality and poverty level in this country? Also, you are there to review the impacts and the drivers of the inequalities to poverty. How does inequality lead to poverty level? And also, we are there to characterize the economical growth, development and action, and ensuring no one is left behind. When we are moving ahead in establishing of the SDGs, and making the implementation of the SDGs and the Vision 2063, African Union Vision 2063, let us see no one is left behind in achieving the vision and reducing the inequality level in the developing countries, and especially in Africa. And also another objective of the study is let us determine the implication of the inequality. So the inequality has a lot of implication to the impact of the poverty. So we have to determine what is the implication of this inequality to level of poverty in developing countries? And lastly, we have to know the poverty rate on income inequality. How is the poverty rate related to inequality level and income? The objective and the relevance of study. From this photo, you can see women, they are the most unpaid work, and they are left out for the and from the paid labor force. For example, women work so much and are paid work. When they are going in their houses, in their homes, they do a lot of work which is not paid for. They take care of the children, they feed the family, they cook for the family, they do the cleaning for the family, as we see from this photo. And also, they are not paid for all this work. How can we make the women and men to be equal, to have better, equal levels of income for us to reduce poverty? And also, the inequality and poverty level is a political choice. By this we mean, you find mostly in developing countries and in Africa, we have what we call lords of poverty, whereby the political class and the ruling class, they want people to remain more poor and more unequal for them to be able to rule them better. Because they believe when people are more rich and have created more wealth, they are not able to rule them. So they make sure that the people are poor and for them to be ruled well. That's why inequality is a political choice from the ruling class. And also, extreme inequality is hurting all of us. When you have extreme poverty, for example, in Soweto, the surrounding area, they experience high crime rate. We experience the global climate change is affecting us out of this extreme inequality we are facing. Through also the GDP, the economic growth, and this GDP growth is brought up by the inequality we are facing. Another statistic that's so much hunting, you find that 170 billion each year is foregone taxes, whereby you have the corporates, the big head of the foreign corporates, companies, the rich people, the super rich people in the world, they don't pay the taxes in the country of the origin operation. They take this money back to their country of origin, leaving the developing country, the Africa also, to be less developed out of the taxes. Another statistic, maybe something we have to note, the 22 richest men have more wealth than all women in Africa. So globally, all the top 22 richest men, they have more wealth, but all compared to all women in Africa. That means women in Africa, they are less empowered, they don't have any stable source of income, and they are mostly involved in informal work, kind of work they do for their day-to-day. And that's another statistic. Richest 1% of world population now own much of the rest of the world. Now, this is a big percentage, whereby 1% own the rest, own more than the rest of the world. How can we bring this inequality level to certain level whereby we have more people who are owning more than the rest? And then You see, the extreme inequality is out of control. Right now, that extreme poverty that is, we are facing globally currently is out of control. The methodology that we used in this study, the sample of 108 countries was collected, and 56 of them were middle and lower level incomes. This study was done globally, so from more developing countries, as we have more countries that participate in the study. And also, an annual time series data from the year 1999 to 2019 to show the economical growth and increase in income inequality in the short run was collected. Secondary data analysis from other researchers from previous studies that were done on this were collected for statistical reasons. Collection of the data was done through the questionnaire, through phone calls, through interviews, through visiting, face-to-face interviews were done for us to collect the data for this research. Experimental design, understanding between the dependent variables and the independent variables, and tested whether or how change in one variable would affect one another, or the other variable. The finding from the study. The poverty level and inequality increase over the period. You find for the 10-year period, the poverty levels have increased and the inequality level has increased over the said period. And also we have great divide in the base of the economic system and values of wealth privilege. From the previous data, you have seen 1% of the richest own more than 22 the rest of the world. And also you see 22 people, the richest people, they own more than the rest of the African women. So this great divide has come in that time of period. And also another finding we came along, unpaid and underpaid work drives growth inequality, whereby you find that women in Africa, they are underpaid or they are not paid for the work they are doing. They do the work, they are not paid, and they don't have formal work to do. Another, half the sampled population lives on less than $1.50 a day, whereby most of the developing countries, they are not able to get $1.50 a day to feed on in their families. So when we see one less than a dollar, you see I'm seeing in a family, maybe a family of four. So you find this family of four, they are living less than $1.50 in a day. Another finding that we came across, under taxing the corporation and wealthy individuals, are underfunding vital public services. So when we attack the big corporates, foreign corporates in the developing countries, we underfund the public services like healthcare, education, sanitation, environment, agriculture, all these are underfunded. And then underfunding of the public services and also giving the decent education, free primary and universal health education, and all these lags because of not really taxing the rich people. And the rich you have in the developing country, they can afford to go to the best schools, get the best medical health care in the developed countries, and their children go to the best school in developed countries. Women, also from the finding, women live in poverty more than men. So you find women are more unequal to men. That's why you find most of the men, women, they are single, and they live in poverty. And when we have more women, they are the breadwinners, they are the head of their families, living more in poverty, so they make the inequality grow more than men. Also, when you go to the workplaces, men are given more opportunities compared to women. So women, they don't get job easily like compared to men. And also, men can do manual work, and they're able to get more income. And also, men can do more than one work where women cannot be able to do. And also, as in a family setup, women have more duties to do in the family, leaving men to do more outside in their working life than women, thus increasing the level of inequality in the developing country. And also, 75% of women in the developing regions are informal economy. So only 25% of women work in the formal economy. So we can only say that to only the 25% have a good source of livelihood, then the 75% don't have good livelihood. And also another finding, inequality is the biggest missing link that can explain the rate of growth in different developing countries, and that can lead to poor education. So if you're able to reduce the inequality we have as a missing link in all the developing countries, the poverty levels we go down. Thus, if we reduce inequality in women, in healthcare, in education, and in agriculture, in environment, we are able to reduce the poverty levels in the areas. Another finding that we came across, inequality is persistent in developing countries. So from that period, we are guided that the developing countries, the level of inequality has persisted to grow. After every year, it has persisted to grow. And that another finding that we came across, the negativity, the inequality has negatively affected the economic growth. So when the level of inequality keeps on growing, the economic activity growth is negatively affected by the inequality we have in. And also increasing income share of the poor and the middle class in fact increase the growth. So if the income is increased for the poor and the middle class, the growth in that area will be able to be affected. Our recommendation, we should make sure everyone has access to decent work and to end the poverty gap and the inequality. So if the women, the men, they're able to get a decent work they can be able to do, the level of inequality is able to be reduced. And to end the extreme poverty and the inequality, we should tax the wealth, the high incomes, the high end, and currently the loopholes and inductive global tax rules, whereby the big corporates, they are able to take their money back to the tax haven. They are not paying the taxes in their country operation in the developing country. The countries that are doing mining in DRC Congo, the countries that are doing mining in South Africa, the countries that are doing operation manufacturing in Africa, in the countries that they are doing their businesses in the developed countries, they are not able to be taxed in the country operation. So the tax should be done in the country operation before the dividends are brought back to the country of origin. And also, they should be encouraged the dividend to be utilized in the country operation than taking back to the country of origin. Another recommendation, globally, governments act now to build human economy, whereby the human are involved in building the economy and the values that truly matter to the society, rather than foreign pursuits for profit. By this, the government should not work so much on making profit growth. They should build human economy that will be able to bridge the gap of inequality in the developing country. And also, adapt developing agenda. When we have a developing agenda based on human economy, the inequality gap will be able to be minimized. The rich and the most powerful, they will be more closer to the poor, such a way that that percentage, that gap will be more bridged and will be not big. Another recommendation, universal access to safe water, sanitation, and domestic energy. If you are seeing that in the picture from Soweto, they don't have good domestic energy, they don't have sanitation. So we are able to reduce that gap compared to Rwanda, and make sure you have universal access to safe water and energy, the inequality gap we have global in the developing country you're able to reduce. And another thing, the regulatory and the legal political framework should be established for the institution, whereby we have regulatory bodies that be able to regulate the inequality. For example, when you go to energy sector, when you go to education, when you go to health sector, you have regulatory authority that's able to control the inequality gap in that areas. Another factor, and another recommendation, we should increase women economic inequality. Let's have more women working in the formal sector. Let's have more women being empowered. Let's not have the women be the home carers only. Let them be out there doing the office work. Let them be in there being the engineers. Let them be the teachers, the nurses, the doctors. Let them be involved more in the formal work. And this will reduce the level of inequality and the level of poverty for everyone in the community. And always the women, they are the backbone of most of the family. So if they are more empowered, the level of inequality will be reduced. And also our recommendation, we should implement fair and equitable agricultural and livestock policies. So when you have a better agricultural livestock policies between the rich, the wealth, and the poor, it will be good, because now you find most of the wealth and the richest people, they are able to export the agricultural products to developed countries, whereas the poor people, the agricultural products, they are bought locally at a very poor prices. So let's have policies that we're able to guide on this area. Another recommendation, let the civil society hold the decision makers to accountable. By this, Every government decision making, let the civil society be involved. Any policy that the governments come to power, let the civil society make the government accountable to this for us to have a fair and more inclusive governance level in all levels of the government. And finally, let's implement universal education and healthcare and social political policies that guarantee free universal services to everybody. The research gap from our research, we established the main research gap that more research needs to be done. Poor agricultural practice and the increase of inequalities, and how is poor agricultural practice and the increasing of inequality, how is it related? And also another research gap, the fiscal policies that are able to reduce the income inequalities, and further, governance and inequality levels. What are the relations between the governance and inequality levels and the poverty levels in developing countries? And also another research gap, the unpaid care work done by women in our homes is established to be more than $10 trillion. How can we be able to reduce this unpaid care? And this is more than 43 times of annual turnover of the Apple company. Another research gap, extreme inequality, class politics. So when people are poor, politicians, they can buy them at little as less than a dollar for them to vote for them in. And the politicians, they don't have good policies for the poor. So out of this, they get the power and they are not able to fight the inequality we have in your society. The challenges, there are several challenges we came across in our research. One, the governance. Governance is a big problem in developing countries. As we have said earlier, the political class, they're always there to fight to betray the poor and those people living in the slums. And also we have the climate changes. Climate changes is affecting inequality in a big way. We don't have equal rights between the women and men. And also poor agricultural policies. Increased debt risk, you find that in the poor country, the developing country, their debt level, they're increasing a very high. And also you find in the poor area, in the developing country, we have high population growth that is more so a challenge to us. In our conclusion, wealth inequality is literally killing all of us. So when we have inequality in the world, it's literally killing everybody. So let us reduce this inequality and let us all be made up an equal level. More so, let us address this inequality without no further delay. From the SDG declaration and from the African Vision 2063, let us address the inequality, the poverty levels without no more delay. Many points have been made on how to reduce the inequality and poverty levels. It's now time to implement the policies without no further delay. Moreover, let's close the gap between the rich and the poor. We have more rich people, as we have seen, that we have very rich people than very poor people. Let's try to bridge this gap between the poor and the rich, and the inequality level will be reduced. At the same time, let us bring to an end the inequality and overcome poverty for good. When you bring to an end the inequality levels in the developing countries, the poverty levels in our country, they will come to an end. Thank you so much. That's the end of my session. Thank you so much for giving this opportunity. If for any question and questions, this is my email, and also this is my telephone number. You can text me, you can WhatsApp me, you can send me the question via email. Thank you so much.